It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back to your feel-good breakfast show. It's Espresso right here on SABC3. Now, we are continuing our series of interviews with local filmmaking talent presently being showcased at the Cape Town International Film Market and Festival. And we have the honour of hosting South Africa's official selection for Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences, or OSCAR, consideration.
Yeah, man, what a privilege it is. Yes, you can clap, you can clap. That's okay. Producer Leila Swart, writer-director Jamil Kubega, and lead actor Ezra Mapengeza of So the Winter to My Skin, a cinematic achievement as audacious as its gallant hero, John Kepe, a kind of Robin Hood of our very own time. Well, they're joining us here to chat to us about it. Thank you for joining us.
Morning, guys.
So early in the morning, I know you must be very, very busy.
You've made it.
Looking at that poster, fiery scenes indeed. So Ezra, tell us about your character and exactly what it is that you are getting up to in this film. Where to start? Where to begin?
Yeah,
so much.
Yeah, it's early, man. I'm not exactly a morning person, but
we hear you.
But this is just a beautiful person.
Yeah.
You know, a powerful man who just wanted to be himself and live his own life.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that's essentially what I got from playing Gap. Just you know, self-determination, and spirituality.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
One man's bandit is another man's champion. Mm-hmm.
Now,
subscript says this.
Leila, I know that you edited and you produced as well, but I think that this is a kind of film that the regular moviegoer has not really experienced before, because there's virtually no dialogue in this movie.
Sure.
How do you bring it to life? How do you make it as gripping as it is without those conventional things that people use to make a movie a hit?
I think that was our primary intention, actually. We were looking at ourselves as filmmakers, as South African filmmakers, as young filmmakers, and going, how do we push our boundaries and how do we test and challenge ourselves in this visual medium?
Yeah.
You know, because I mean, I think we're very well-versed in writing and and talking and speaking and using the spoken word. And we thought, you know, the visual medium of cinema is such a visual thing. So let's push ourselves and challenge ourselves to tell a story through imagery.
And it challenges the actor as well.
Oh, definitely.
100%.
I find the title most intriguing, and I want to know the origins of the story.
Sure. Well, I mean, as a phrase, what it alludes to, I believe, is a contemplative soul. When you look back at your life, even the most painful moments you wear as a suit of armor, you know? So metaphorically, I believe that as South Africans, we can look back at apartheid and we sew it onto our skin because it made us who we are now, the resilient people that we are now. So that's where the title comes
from. Sure, I just literally got goosebumps when you said that. That is so powerful. Now, JP's sitting there with bated breath. He's such a happy right now. And he asked me to name the following greats: No Country for Old Men, There Will Be Blood, Children of Men, Django Unchained, Taxi Driver, The Revenant. I mean, the listing, you know, it's been going on and on. He's still been struggling to kind of make, not struggling, but he's been loving this movie since Wednesday.
He cannot stop talking about it. Yeah, yeah.
How do you feel when you hear people engage with a film on this level?
Deeply humbled.
Yeah.
I mean, essentially, we make films for them to be seen and to be engaged, you know? And one of the things that I find fascinating about filmmaking is the idea that the minute that you put it on a screen, it belongs to each individual person.
Mm.
It's no longer my film or Layla's film or Ezra's film. It becomes something that is owned by that person based on their own past and their life experiences.
Yeah.
So I find the idea of engaging filmmaking quite an amazing process, just in terms of humanity and just how we view that movie.
Yeah. I mean, I'm assuming it is an extraordinary privilege and an honor to have been named the official South African selection at the Oscars. So I'll let that just kind of sink in, but I want to know, what do you hope each viewer will gain from this film after walking out of the cinema?
I mean, I think that's the beauty, piggybacking off what Jamil was saying, is that the fact that there's no dialogue allows each person to have ownership of this film. So that's the answer to the question, man.
And I think for me, it's about the exporting of culture. Why I'm really happy about the being representing South Africa is that I think it's important for us to take ownership of our heroes in a way that we send it out into the world and say this is ours and this is our perspective on those heroes, you know, which is what I'm
And I do also want to shout out to the people that gave the submission, which is the NFEF and the panel that they chose. Mm-hmm. I mean, that committee that chose us is a committee made up of our peers. So that is an honor in itself. Everything else is gravy, so we're really deeply humbled by that.
It's all good when it's gravy.
It's all good. It's great. We love some gravy.
Thank you guys for just making great South African films, man.
Thank you for the interview.
You've got to go and watch this. Guys, give it up. Come on, guys. Our official nomination at the Oscars. Oh, so the winter to my skin. It'll be screening at the Cape Town International Film Market and Festival on the 16th of October, then off to Oscar glory. Don't miss a very unique opportunity for an old tale brought to now.
Exactly, and you can find out more about it all by visiting sowthewintertomyskin.com. And to find out what else is on show at the festival, click your way over to filmfestival.capetown.